Good morning, children. In this chapter, you will discuss about the properties of metals, non-metals, and their compounds. We can learn about what is metal, non-metal. Then, what do you mean by the characters of metal and non-metals? Then, we can move to our sixth chapter, that is metal and non-metals. In this chapter, we can learn about elements. We already learned what is elements. Then the elements can be classified into three parts. Which are the three parts? Metals, metalloids and non-metals. Elements can be classified on the basis of their properties and nature. Elements can be classified into metals, non-metals and metalloids. And in this chapter, you will learn about the properties and the uses of metals and non-metals and their compounds. Then, moving to metal and non-metals. We know that the aluminium and iron are the most abundant metal in the earth crust. Then, which one is the most abundant metal in earth crust? That is aluminium and iron. And which one is the most abundant non-metal in the earth crust? Answer, that is oxygen, and also followed by silicon. Then some metals are occurring in free state. Can you say the examples of free states of metals? Examples, gold, silver and platinum. They are found in free state of earth crust. Then these metals are reactive, and also it combined with some non-metals to form oxides, hydroxides, carbonate and sulfides. Then metals and non-metals show different properties. There are some exceptions also there. Let us see the comparison of general properties of metals and non-metals. Then we can learn about the properties, comparison of general properties of metal and non-metal. First of all, we discuss about what are the properties. The first property, that is the physical state, and second one strength, and third one luster, then fourth one malleability, then fifth one ductility, and sixth one conductivity. Seventh one, sonority. Then eighth one, melting and boiling point. And the last one, that is tensile strength. Then how it compare metal and non-metal, these properties? Then physical state. The first property, that is physical state. In metals, most metals are solid at room temperature. One exception is their mercury, that is in liquid form. In non-metals, the physical state is either solid or gaseous at room temperature. Here also one exception is there, that is bromine, which is liquid in nature. Then in comparing to the strength, metals are very hard and strong. Exception also, they are sodium and potassium, they are soft. Then in non-metals are not very strong, except diamond, which is an allotrope of carbon. Can you say what do you mean by allotrope? Allotrope is different physical forms in which an element can exist. Then the third property, that is luster. Then all the metals have luster. That luster means shining property. Example, copper, gold. Then that's why we use ornaments, gold. Then non-metals are dull. Exceptions are also there, iodine and graphite. Then the next property, that is malleability. All the metals are highly malleable. Then exception also, they are zinc, antimony and arsenic have some exceptions. In non-metals are brittle. Here also one except crystals of iodine. Then next property, ductility. Metals are ductile. Then non-metals are non-ductile. They can break on stretching. Then the conductivity. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Example, copper, aluminium, etc. Then the non-metals, they are bad conductors of heat and electricity. Then a next property, that is sonority. That means producing sound. That means metals are sonorous and non-metals are non-sonorous. Then melting and boiling point. Metals have high melting and boiling point. Then non-metals, they have low boiling and melting point. Then the tensile strength. Metals are highly tensile. Some examples of metals with high tensile strength are iron, copper, aluminium, etc. Then non-metals, they are low tensile strength except carbon fibers. And these are the properties, general properties of metals and non-metals. In this chapter, we learn about the properties of metals, and that means the comparison of metals and non-metals. I think you all understood this topic. Thank you all.